Hi, happy Pi Day, and welcome to Day 10 of Wave. I'm Daniel Bogdanoff. We'll draw the winner for today in a moment, but first, let's look at today's tip, which looks at how to get more than the allotted power from your power supply. Triple output power supplies are great, but sometimes you need more power than just one channel can provide. We know that a triple output power supply can supply power to multiple channels at once, so the total power generation capability of the box has to be greater than the generation capability of a single channel. So what do you do if you want to harness the box's power into just one output? You could go get a higher wattage power supply, or you could combine your supply's outputs using a serial or parallel connection. Essentially, a serial setup gives you double the voltage output at the same current, and a parallel setup gives you double the current output capabilities at the same voltage. You can set this up the old school way by externally wiring outputs together and setting up a reverse bias diode to avoid blowing up your supplies, or you can use a power supply with parallel and serial connections built right in. Let's take a look at a series connection. So you can see right now I'm piping 5 volts into my dummy load here. I'm gonna go ahead now and put in 25.75 volts, which is the maximum output for this channel. And we can see that if I try to crank up my voltage, I can only turn it down, I can't turn it up. That tells me I'm definitely at the output max for channel 2. If I wanna get more voltage out of this, I can set up a series connection. So I'm gonna go to output settings, operation mode, and then I'm going to change my mode from independent, and independent, all the channels are operating independently of each other. In series mode, I can now use the plus terminal from channel 2 and the ground terminal from channel 3, so I'm going to slide this over. Usually you turn the output voltage off before you do that. I'm going to turn it on, we're going to go back to channel 2's menu here. I'm going to back out of these menus. So you can see that I'm getting 50 volts across my resistor, and my DMM does confirm that. So the nice thing about this power supply is that all of the routing from channel 2 to channel 3 is done internally and controlled via software, so you don't have to do any external connection of these posts. For more power supply tips, check out the app note, 10 practical tips to help your power supply testing and analysis. And that app note is in the Wave library and linked in the video description. And now let's draw today's winner. Remember, the last schematic challenge question is up today, and if that gets answered correctly through Facebook, we'll give away 3 more 1000X series scopes on Friday. And today's winner is Ethan Busberg. Congratulations, Ethan. We'll be in touch with you shortly. A couple quick things. The Wave library is closing down on Monday, so make sure to save off any ebooks or app notes you haven't gotten around to reading yet. Second, if your entry button isn't working, try clearing your cache and your cookies, or go in from a different browser, and that should fix it. If that doesn't work, you can still go to that form entry page, and the system will recognize your information and add that to your set of daily entries. Finally, check out the schematic challenge, and if you're not on Facebook, you can still actually see those questions on our blog. The link for that is in the description as well. That's all for today. I'll see you tomorrow. Hi, happy Pi Day. It's day 10 of Wave. Actually, I don't want to gesture the pies. I'm kind of against, like, defaulting to celebrating Pi Day with pies. Like, I'm all in favor of eating pie, but I feel like just because they sound the same, they're not the same word, so. But I do like pie. Mmm. Is that good?